Hello there, I'm Andrew from the Visual Crossing engineering team. Today I'm going to show how to download weather data to your computer. I'm going to use the Visual Crossing website and we're going to download data for New York City. So let's get started by looking at our website on the screen. And you can see if you go to the home page, the first thing you can do is hit this big download data link, and that actually takes you to our Weather Query Builder tool. And the Weather Query Builder is a way of viewing weather data, downloading weather data, and also building weather API queries. And you can look at forecast data or historical data. Right now on the screen, you can see I've got New York City, New York, with the next 15-day forecast. And I'm currently showing the data as metric information. If you wanted to show it in US units, I can click on the top right here and switch to US. And now you can see that I've got Fahrenheit for my temperature. If we go over to the right-hand side, we'll see the download button, and we're going to use this button to download the weather data. So we hit on download, and it gives us a couple of options. The first option is what format would we like the weather data in, and you can see we can choose between CSV, comma-separated values, Excel, or JSON. We're going to choose CSV because it's one of the most commonly used formats of data, and we can use it to import into many applications like Excel or Google Sheets. And then on the right-hand side, you can choose which table of data you want to import. Do you want to choose the daily level data, the hourly data, or some of the other data such as the severe weather alerts or the current conditions? We're going to choose the daily level data and we're going to hit continue. It gives us the opportunity to name our data set. We click forward, hit run query. Now the data is sent to our backend and it collects the data. In this case, it's going to be pretty fast, but you could run many locations for many more days of historical data, and that would take a little longer. But now you can see that the data is already ready for download. So I can hit the download button and it brings it to my local computer. And if I open that up, you can see CSV has been already configured to open in Excel. So Excel opens up and you can see that I have the data right in front of me that we just saw in the web browser. So it's ready for now me to work with directly within Excel. Thank you very much for watching. Over the coming weeks, we're going to be working on many more videos regarding how to build your first weather API query, how to schedule download data so that you can run them at the same time every day if you want to update, for example, an Excel sheet. So please check back often. And if you have any comments, please leave them in the comments below. Thank you very much.